Hi, in today's bite, you will learn what business intelligence is and how it is related to HR analytics. If you're not familiar with the buzzwords business intelligence, also known as BI, it is in fact an umbrella term. Business intelligence includes the application, infrastructure, tools, and best practices that enable access to and analysis of information to optimize decision-making and performance. Organizational data is often stored in different separate systems which do not communicate with each other. For example, it's easy to check who left the organization and who is a high performer. However, it's harder to check which high performers left the organization in the past year, as this requires combining data from two different systems. In line with this, your sales data are usually not combined with your inventory data or your site visitors. However, tools combining these data can show you which customers actually bought something, which then entails the combination of site data with sales data, or what items are about to be sold out and should therefore be restocked, which translates into a combination of inventory with sales data. These are great examples of business intelligence tools. Now, how does BI apply to HR? Similar to our sales example, business intelligence can also be used for HR data. Your applicant tracking system and your performance management system are usually not combined, which prevents you from analyzing which hires perform best. Business intelligence tools, however, can help you combine these data, after which it will be much easier to perform the following three things. First, aggregating data. Most HR reporting consists of ad hoc reporting, meaning that different extracts are manually combined. Here, BI tools can facilitate data aggregation and enable automated reporting. Second, visualizing data. Most HR systems are transactional systems that generate transactional data. Transaction data describes an event using a time dimension and a value which refers to one or more objects. For example, a candidate is hired on a certain date. A few months later, their contract is terminated on a certain date. Both actions are recorded as separate entries or transactions in the system. These systems are built to keep records as opposed to visualizing and reporting data, whereas BI tools are really good at aggregating this transactional data from multiple systems and visualizing it. Third, analyze data. The final step is data analytics. Keep in mind that BI tools are much better at analyzing data than your average HR system. Such examples are Power BI and SAS, as they enable you to statistically analyze large quantities of data. As a bottom line, remember that BI tools are made to aggregate, visualize, analyze, and report data. And now, let's have a look at some examples of BI tools. A few of the best-known BI tools in HR are Click, Visier, Tableau, and Power BI. Now let's have a quick look at each of them individually. Visier brands itself as a workforce analytics solution with a similar application. It aggregates data from various systems and helps in the analysis of this data. Click and Tableau both brand themselves as data visualization tools that serves as connectors to all your information systems. Microsoft's Power BI will feel more natural to analysts who are used to working in Excel and is particularly useful when a lot of reporting happens in Excel. By the way, we included Power BI in our HR Analyst course, and it's very easy to use. If you're interested, check out the course if you haven't already by clicking on the link in the description. Now that we have defined and exemplified business intelligence and BI tools, let's take a closer look into its relationship with HR analytics. A lot of the business intelligence tools do what most people refer to as HR analytics. However, in reality, this is not always true. BI tools in HR are very good at connecting different systems, visualizing data, and assisting in reporting on this data. However, these tools are not so good in performing actual data analytics. Instead, software packages that specialize in doing these analytics, like SPSS and R, do this much better. If you are interested to read more about these and other tools, check our overview of the top 5 HR analytics tools, which you will find in the description of this video. Technically, these tools could fit into the business intelligence category. They are, however, usually seen as standalone tools. This is because the analytics process requires a well-defined research question that is specific to the organization's context, culture, and data quirks. This is very hard to automate in the BI system, and that's why the real analysis in HR are typically manually performed by data experts. If you are interested to learn more about BI and HR analytics, remember to check out the links in the description, and make sure you stay up to date with our daily bites by subscribing to our channels. Also, if you like this video, make sure you like and share it, and I'll see you soon in the next Daily Bite.